This graph shows the historical levels of CO2 in our atmosphere extracted from an Antarctic ice core. You can clearly see that there is a quite pronounced drop in global CO2 levels after the discovery of America in 1492. This drop also coincides with the coldest part of the Little Ice Age, with temperatures up to 1.5 degrees lower than today. Now the question is if the discovery of the Americas actually caused this drop, or if something entirely else was responsible. And if Columbus actually is responsible for the coldest part of the Little Ice Age, we still have to figure out how that happened. My name is David, and this is Unfinished Earth. Before anything else, we first have to take a look at the situation in America before the arrival of European explorers. We're going to start more than 500 years ago, before the continent was discovered by Christopher Columbus. At that time, the indigenous population on the continent was thriving. Today, it is estimated that before the arrival of European explorers, about 60 million people inhabited the continent. With only about 400 million people alive at that time in total, the indigenous population in America was by no means small. But as is the case even today, the population wasn't distributed evenly. There were big differences between the population density and the culture of the tribes in North, Middle, and South America. North America at that time had a comparably small population of only about 4 million, and with a few local exceptions, the Native Americans mainly got their food from foraging and hunting. But while North America didn't have the biggest population, parts of Middle and South America were dense. In what is Mexico today, there were living about 30 million people, and the Inca territory in South America was home to another 16 million people. So while a lot of Native Americans, especially in the northern parts of North America, lived with the land and didn't have a very high impact on the ecosystem, the bigger populations in Mexico and South America were forced to use their available land more intensively than North American tribes to be able to feed everyone. That's why in denser parts of America, there's evidence for widespread use of slash and burn techniques to clear the forest for farming. There's even evidence for the use of complex irrigation systems by some tribes. What is also very well known is the terracing of the steep slopes of the Andean mountains by the Incas to grow corn or quinoa. Now everything that I've told you so far doesn't really explain how the climate changed, but it's essential to understand all the processes that kicked into effect once Columbus arrived in America. As you probably know, Columbus didn't just bring a few ships and a very different culture to America, he also brought diseases that didn't exist in the New World before his arrival. Everything from smallpox and measles to influenza and the bubonic plague were introduced to the native population. And it didn't stop there either. Later on, malaria, diphtheria, typhus, and cholera were also added to the list. And all of these new diseases spread like wildfire, every outbreak killing huge parts of the native population. Reports from that time show that in southern Mexico, a single outbreak of smallpox killed about 30 to 50% of the indigenous population. And since epidemics like that occurred in rapid succession, each killing a substantial amount of the population, it is estimated that just 100 years after first European contact, more than 90% of the initial indigenous population had disappeared. They were killed by disease, or more directly, by European exploitation and warfare. Now, with a much lower population, there weren't enough workers left to tend to all of the agricultural land. So in the 100 years since Columbus' arrival, the majority of the land used by Native Americans was abandoned. In total, it is estimated that more than 500,000 square kilometers were abandoned after the arrival of Columbus. That corresponds to an area bigger than the whole state of California. And this is where we get back to our graph of CO2 levels. This drop of atmospheric CO2 is caused by forests and other secondary vegetation regrowing on land that was burned or otherwise cleared by the Native Americans so that they can use it for farming. In the following 100 years after the discovery of America, 7.4 billion metric tons of CO2 were bound in the form of biomass, causing the Earth to cool down on a global scale. As far as we know today, this was the biggest single event of human-made climate change second only to the Industrial Revolution and the change in climate that is happening today. If you would like to know more about the details and the science behind this topic, there are some scientific papers in the description for further reading. Other than that, since this is the first YouTube video I ever made, I would really appreciate some feedback. So if you like this video, please leave a like or a comment. And if this all gets some good feedback, you can definitely subscribe, because more videos like this will be coming soon. Alright, I will hopefully see you in the next video.